Any chance I get to talk about this movie is gonna be a good day. Hey there, creepy peeps. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Vicky, and I talk about horror movies, books, other spooky stuff all year round. So you should definitely subscribe and become a creepy peep today, if you like this video, of course. So this is a patron requested video. If you want to support my channel in a different way, you can give my Patreon a once over. We have game nights, exclusive content, movie hangouts, and of course, the perk of requesting a video like this one. Follow the link in the description to find out more. This video is twofold because not only is it a requested video, but it's also requested specifically as a horror education video. Horror education is a series where I explore movies, books, topics, and horror through the lens of being a queer person. It's mostly for my own education, and I thought some of y'all might like it as well, so here we are. Directed by Joachim Trier, hopefully I said that right. Thelma is a hybrid coming of age, superhero, supernatural, horror, thriller, love story. I know there's a lot going on here, and I'll get into the finer details of the plot, but the quick summary is that the movie is following Thelma, who's experiencing a resurgence of a long dormant telekinetic power when she goes off to college and falls in love with one of her classmates, Anya. Jumping right into it, this is ultimately a movie about religious trauma, specifically within the LGBTQ+ community. Through Thelma's relationship with her parents and her budding relationship with Anya, we see a really compassionate but also realistic look at something a lot of LGBTQ+ people experience. Not all, but some. And just because these sort of movies don't always end well for queer characters, I am gonna spoil just one thing that I don't think any of you are gonna mind if I spoil. This movie does have a happy ending. There is no burying of the gays in this movie. Let's talk about Thelma's parents first really quick. When the movie opens, we see this really quietly horrifying scene where Thelma and her father are going out hunting and they find a deer. While Thelma is focused on the deer, her father turns and points the gun at her while she's not paying attention. Kind of like in the biblical story of Abraham, Thelma's father almost feels compelled, we'll learn later on, by God to kill his daughter. We immediately cut to the present with Thelma away at college, and we kind of get glimpses of Thelma's relationship to her parents through the incessant phone calls. Like everyday phone calls where they're asking her, like, what did you do today? What did you eat? Are you outside right now? Be careful. At first it seems normal, then it quickly feels very oppressive and controlling, and we don't really have an idea of where that's coming from until a scene early on when Thelma's parents have come to visit her in the city and they're out to eat. They end up having a conversation specifically about evolution versus creation, I assume because Thelma's a biology major in the movie. And Thelma kind of gets in trouble with her dad for making fun of some family friends. She says in the movie, like, they think that the world started like 6,000 years ago or something like that. And Thelma's father says to her, a little knowledge doesn't make us better than others, which I wanted to point out because that's our first little hint to some Garden of Eden imagery that pops up a couple of times throughout the movie. It comes mostly into play with the introduction of Anya. I think of Thelma in the movie as a sort of Eve figure. So up until this point in the movie, she's been living in the garden, AKA under the watchful, super religious eye of her parents and the small town that she's from, that have kept her powers and her sexuality dormant. I'm gonna keep mentioning her powers and her sexuality together because they are definitely linked in this movie. They're a pair. The first time Thelma meets Anya, it's when she sits next to Thelma at the library and it triggers a seizure in Thelma. The first one in the film and the awakening of Thelma's sexuality slash power. I just want to make a small little aside right here. I did some Does This Offend You caliber reaching. Just looked up what the name Thelma meant. Why do I feel the need to look up characters' names all the time? I don't know. Most of the time, it doesn't really mean anything to the movie, but in this case, I think it does. The name Thelma actually means will or volition, which is cool considering Thelma's power, which is to make something happen, make something appear or disappear, simply because she wants it to. We see this first happen when Thelma is thinking about Anya before bed and Anya is mysteriously compelled to come to Thelma's apartment. And like I mentioned before, Thelma's power and her sexuality become linked with Anya as the driving force because it just so happens to be what Thelma wants most within the reality of this movie. Even to the point when they go to the ballet, Anya touches Thelma's thigh and she starts to make like this giant light on the ceiling start to sway. It's the first time we kind of see this power as maybe being a little destructive. Thelma obviously gets scared in this moment because, I mean, at that point, what could happen? That whole light could just come down and kill everybody just because Anya was touching her thigh. So this scares Thelma and she runs away after sharing a kiss with Anya to try and pray the gay away, as it were. We then see Thelma try and play straight and show up to a party with a boy. She drinks a lot at this party to try and bury her feelings for Anya. Some more stretching here. This one's a bit more of a stretch, I think, than the meaning of Thelma's name. But I see the wine in this scene as the apple. on the tree of knowledge. And my only link is that wine is made of grapes, which is a fruit, and apple is also a fruit. I think it makes sense because when you drink, your inhibitions get lowered. And that's exactly what happens to Thelma in this scene. Her inhibitions lower and she ends up hallucinating a really steamy makeout scene with Anya that ends in this imagery of Thelma being wrapped up by a snake. Another obvious reference to the tree of knowledge, the snake that tempts Eve. The sequence that follows plays like Thelma has voluntarily signed herself up for conversion therapy under the guise of trying to get to the bottom of her seizures. In the climax of this sequence, a doctor is trying to trigger a seizure in Thelma, which for any photosensitive creepy peeps out there, big warning for this movie, there is a kind of extended scene of flashing lights and sound. But like I was saying, the doctor is trying to trigger a seizure in Thelma. So he keeps bringing up certain stressful things and he mentions possibly somebody she may like. And of course she starts thinking about Anya and her brain activity kicks up. But the doctor keeps referring to this as a difficult thought. And I don't think that's by mistake. Because at this point, Thelma knows she loves Anya, but she believes that it's wrong. So Thelma ends up having another seizure in this moment, but this time she makes Anya disappear. She's super distraught by this, so she returns home back to her parents, who give her this super intense drug to keep her docile. And we learn through flashbacks that Thelma did a similar thing to her newborn baby brother and made him disappear in a rather gruesome way. And then as Thelma's father puts it, she found God and then got better. This flashback gives us some important insight that while her parents are very controlling, that is true, they are also terrified of Thelma. And who scares Christian extremists more than gay people? Thelma realizes this. She sets out to take out the source of her religious trauma, which is not any God, but her father. I think this is a super important distinction in the movie because I could go all day about how I personally believe that like the Christian God is not actually a good God like at all. But there are lots of sects of Christianity that do support the LGBTQ plus community. And I've seen many, I don't know necessarily what they'd be referred to, like pastors or reverends or church leaders that are actually a part of the LGBTQ community also. But this film deftly points out that the thing most responsible for religious trauma is people and not necessarily religion itself. So once her father is gone, Thelma is able to harness her power, and instead of making somebody disappear, she ends up being able to find Anya and bring her back to this reality. Cue happy ending music. Thelma returns to school and we see her and Anya being super cute and in love. No catch. Thelma just had to get over her religious trauma by killing her father. But benefits outweigh the cost. I really do love talking about this movie. I think it handles religious trauma in such an interesting way. And I obviously love the idea that Thelma's sexuality is linked to her power in the movie. Society, just in general, is afraid of feminine sexuality. Like in the movie, yes, Thelma's power is kind of fearsome. She can do some pretty scary stuff, but then she is able to gain control over it and harness it after she takes out that patriarchal influence. But I really, really appreciate the understated cute ending. Like everyone is just so afraid of Thelma, but all she wanted was to just go out with this cute girl. That's it. Overall, Thelma is just a great LGBTQ horror movie and under discussed. So shout out to Dez for requesting this video. Thank you. Once again, you can check out my Patreon page to find out more about requesting a video or just other perks. And if you've seen Thelma, let me know your thoughts on it in the comments. I do hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new here. Become a creepy peep today. And I will see you soon with a new video. Until then, stay strange. Bye.